Hey everyone, and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be sharing with you guys my current favorites. I think the last favorites video I filmed was like for June or July, but I just don't try out as much products as I used to. I just don't have the time, so I feel like if I do these every single month, they get kind of repetitive, but I have some really good items here. I've got some books, some clothing, some skincare, some makeup, some like lifestyle stuff, so just a bunch of different things. I definitely enjoy incorporating more than just like makeup and skincare in my favorites videos, so yeah, I'm going to go ahead and get started. I do want to say, I know I do feel like I look like a lumberjack with this like flannel on, but I really, really like it, especially with like leggings. But anyways, in case you guys are wondering what's on my eyes, it's that Smith & Cult Fiery Copper, but this was really hard to work with. Like it took my eyeshadow forever because I kept like having to go back and blend and it was just starting to look muddy and I got tired of fooling with it. So I just let it go. So it is what it is. But anyways, all right, let's go ahead and get these skincare out of the way. So this is the Aveeno Calm and Restore Triple Oat Serum. And you guys are going to see, like, I have used a lot of this. It's like, if it'll focus on it, there we go. It's like almost completely gone, but I really, really like this. So I actually use this before my moisturizer. I don't use this on its own. So I feel like this is one of those products that like when I put this on my skin, it's like almost like an immediate like reaction. My skin just kind of calms down, especially if I'm like having to treat any sort of acne or breakouts and I need something to like go in with after. This is just really, really nice. So I will say, I think this is a little more on the pricey side. I'm thinking it's around like the $20, $28, might be somewhere around there mark, but I do really, really like this. And if you're someone who wants like something that's really lightweight, like a serum to go underneath your moisturizer, because like, here's the thing with me. So this is not like enough moisture or anything to like wear on its own. I definitely have to go over top it with a moisturizer, but it's like adding this extra step just really like calms my skin down. And then I feel like my moisturizer over top of it, it just works really, really well. But I really, really like this. I actually purchased the oat toner from First Aid Beauty, which actually just got here. FedEx just dropped off a package. So I'm excited to try that out, but I love this. And if you're looking for something that's, you know, a little bit more affordable, like from the drugstore, then this is a really good one. The next is actually from, now is this one pronounced? So how's this one's pronounced? I know that one's Avene, right? Or Avene, oh gosh, I don't know. This is A-V-E-N-E. So this is their thermal spring water. This is actually like a smaller sample size that I got sent. But I really like this, especially if I have a full face of makeup on like I do today. I usually have to go in with like a oil cleanser to kind of help break everything down. And then I go in and cleanse my skin. Sometimes I feel like my skin can just feel like a little bit sensitive and I just want something to soothe it. And I'm telling you guys, just like spraying this on my face, like I'm telling you, on the days I don't wear makeup, I will like come grab this off my makeup desk and just spray it on my face. And it just feels so, so good. Like, I'll be honest, I used to feel like I'm someone that would have thought a product like this, I'm like, you don't need that. That's so stupid. But like, I love this. I'm telling you, just get it and just try it out. It just, even if it just doesn't do anything, it feels good. It feels really, really good on your skin. But I've really been loving this and enjoying this. And I know my skincare has definitely been like a lot better, like my whole skin in general. And I think it's because I've been like just switching out some products, but I've also been drinking a lot more water and eating a lot better and limiting my intake of sugar. So that's probably what it is. But this is just something that's really, really soothing. If you want like some kind of spray, this is definitely a really, really good one just to kind of soothe your skin. Even before you go to put your makeup on, that's a really, really good one. All right. I do have a few makeup products here. So this is an oldie, but a goodie. Like this is the MAC Blush and Blush Baby. And so when I say oldie, like I feel like no one mentions MAC blushes anymore, but like I just fell in love with this. So this is the Sheer Tone Blush, and these have like, I don't know if MAC changed their formula, but this has a very like, I'm barely touching it. It feels like silk, but look how pigmented that is. This is just so pretty. This is that perfect like blush for me personally in the fall or the winter. But this is like, I don't know, were MAC blushes always this good or did they reformulate them? This is like the perfect matte blush, but it's like sheer, so it looks like skin, but really smooth, but not too matte at the same time. I don't know. There was something that like has been so magical about this blush. Like I've been obsessed with it. I'm actually wearing the Huda Beauty one I tried on because I do really like it. But like, guys, when I tell you this is probably this blush and one other has been like one of the only blushes I've been reaching for the last few months. Like, I love it. It's absolutely gorgeous. Like, the MAC blushes, I feel like, again, MAC is just a brand that I feel like, I don't know, a lot of people's forgotten about, but this is such a good blush. Such a good blush and a beautiful fall color, especially if you have more fair to light skin. Absolutely love it. All right. I hate mentioning limited edition products, so I'll just speak about this for a second. But this is a Clinique Cheek Pop, and you guys are going to see mine's like super dirty and messy. But this specific shade right here, do you guys know what shade this is? So this was a limited edition trio by Clinique. I want to get this on its own because I love this color. The Clinique blushes, I think, are very unique. I feel like you either love them or you hate them. They're more of like a sheer blush, but you build them up and it gives that very beautiful, I want to feel like natural flush with a very like slight glow, but they're very sheer. But that's what kind of makes them unique, is that the ability where even though they're sheer, you can still build them up, but they never go overboard and they still look so natural and they just blend in this into the skin so beautifully. I just love the Clinique Cheek Pops. Again, I feel like it's a product that I used to rave and rave about, and I'm so glad that I've fallen back in love with this palette because it's, I mean, it is really, really good. And again, if you guys know this blush, I want the like actual like cut, like single one of its own, because I do love it. This shade right here, I do really like in the summertime. Usually I'll mix these two to give a little more warmth to this blush. This one's just a little bit too deep for me, but they're all still, like I said, really pretty, and the formula is really nice. Did Clinique do a holiday one of these this year? I don't remember seeing that, but yeah. Anyways, okay. I want to talk about this foundation because I love this. So this is the Merit, Perfecting Complexion Stick. I have the shade Linen. I love this. If you want to see this in action, I have a full video trying out all of their products, but I love this foundation. So basically, this is a stick foundation, which I'll be honest, I was someone who was not a huge fan of stick foundation, so I was really skeptical about this. But it's all it is. I just make sure not to like put it up too far because, you know, stick foundations can kind of break. But this literally applies your skin like butter. But then you go in with this brush and it's like, I feel like you need the brush. If you're going to get the foundation, you need the brush. Because this is like soft, but it still blends everything so seamlessly. And I feel like it works better with this foundation than any other brush that I actually have in my collection. But I love this one. It looks incredibly beautiful. It lasts a long time on the skin. The only thing is, like I said, with masks and stuff, just like any other foundation, it does fade on my nose, right here on my chin, a little bit on my cheeks where my mask is touching it. But, you know, again, that's just going to happen. But this looks incredibly smooth. It glides over top of my acne. It doesn't grip around or enhance it. I really, really like this. I feel like this is a very underrated foundation. And if you guys haven't tried it out, I definitely would recommend it and the brush. And then I do have one other product I want to mention. So from that brand, it's the Tinted Lip Oil. So this is the All Natural shade. It's actually what I've got on. I do have a lip liner underneath here. But for this to be a lip oil, this has a pretty good amount of pigment. And it's not super slippy. I feel like a lot of lip oils can be very like slippy on the lip. They're kind of hard to wear with a lip liner because they'll even like move the lip liner around. But this one isn't like this one, like that. And it is so incredibly comfortable on the lips. Feels really nice and hydrating. Like my lips never feel dry when I wear this. And I just love the packaging. It's so, so incredibly cute. But yes, absolutely love this. Like, you gotta try it out. But if you're someone who likes a gloss that's like thicker, I feel like more juicy looking, than the Alamar Cosmetics blush in Dulce, I believe. This is, I really, really love this. So this is a product that I know I've mentioned before, but I fell back in love with this because this looks great over top of that Pat McGrath lip liner that I mentioned in my last favorites. This is so pretty. Like, oh my God. Sorry, it's just so pretty. But this is a thicker gloss. I don't want to say it's like gummy, but it's definitely on the thicker side. So it's one of those things where I'll apply it pretty heavily, like towards more like the bottom. Does that make sense? And the top. And then I'll just lightly kind of pat my lips more around the center because it's one of those that kind of can like, when you press your lips together right here in the center, it can kind of do that where it's tacky. It's not bad, but if you like that thicker gloss, I feel like that's to be expected. But guys, it's, again, incredibly beautiful. That perfect warm nude. I just absolutely love this. So I had to mention that one as well. Okay. Now moving on to, actually, a sports bra. Let me just wipe this off my hand here so I don't get this everywhere. So this is from Amazon. I will link this sports bra down below because I do not know the brand, but I know I can find it in my purchases. So this is like a one shoulder, it's kind of hard to see, I feel like a sports bra. You have this cute little open gap right here, but this is a really, really nice material. So it's not that like cotton material, but it's also not that like really slippy material. It's like that in between, which I really, really like. But this actually makes my boobs look huge, and I'm an A. I wear a 32A. I wear a small in this sports bra, and this is pretty snug. So I honestly feel like anytime like I gain a little bit of weight or that time of the month, I feel like my boobs get bigger, This is a little bit snug and a little bit tight, but I feel like a medium would be too big. But this is so incredibly flattering. Me and my sister do silks and lyra, and what I like about this bra is, can you guys see how thick this band is? A lot of times with like sports bras, that'll kind of just, they're like one solid piece. Does that make sense? If they have a very thin band, when that band folds on the inside, which I hate, but this one hasn't done. But this is like, I mean, I'm telling you guys, it like holds in around like your rib cage. It gives a lot of support where it's a little bit thicker. It's a little bit longer. So it looks really good with high-waisted leggings. And it's just so incredibly flattering. I haven't seen anybody talk about this. Like, it's cute. If you want a super cute sports bra, like, this is it. But anyways, what I was saying about this thick band. So with a lot of sports bras, if like I'm in the lyra and I'm holding my sister and like I'm leaning back, if that makes sense, a lot of times sports bras will kind of do that thing where they start to roll up. This does not do that whatsoever because the band is really, really nice and thick. Again, the back is the same way. You have this super cute little hole right here. Looks really flattering. A ton of support just to be on one shoulder. And I mean, just holds everything in place and just looks really, really good. So, sorry about that, guys. Like, all my Black Friday orders are getting here. Like, FedEx was just here earlier, which I don't know if I mentioned or not. And then that was just UPS. Now all we're missing is USPS to deliver a package. But anyways, moving right along. So I actually want to talk about these. So these are like little, like, nipple pasties kind of. So this is from the brand Queen's Secret. And if you are someone who, like I said, is small-chested like me, if you try have like any dress that's like a really deep V or doesn't have a back or anything like that, and you've tried those bras, like a lot of the ones that are like backless, that you just, they sit right here and you pull them together and attach them. You guys know what I'm talking about? Those are, one, so incredibly uncomfortable. And two, you can still see them with that deep V. Well, I have tried the little flower petal pasties, but one, you can see the lining in those and they just look really bad. And two, they literally just make your, they just make everything look more pointy. I don't know. I just don't like them. But guys, I'm telling you, if you have smaller like boobs, you need these. So this actually comes with two sets. You have this set in here, which I have not used. Right here, it still has the plastic on them and everything. But these are two that I have used, and these are reusable. So these have like that silicone kind of feel. They are like, guys, they're so thin. Like they're even, I feel like, thinner than paper. They're like paper thin, where like the center goes. But what's really great is this part's sticky. So like you can stick this and like pull up and it still like lifts, but and like gives you a little bit of something while looking like seamlessly, where you can wear anything. Like, guys, I wear tight tank tops with these because these are nice. If you don't want to wear a bra that day, just put these on and you're good to go. I've sweated in these. They don't move. Like, I love these. I discovered these when we went to Wilmington, me and my sister, back in, I think it was August. And I love these. I got to wear so many cute shirts that I hadn't been able to wear for years, like backless ones, because I hate how those regular bras feel. But again, if you are someone who has smaller boobs, like, definitely try these out, because I do think that these will work. They'll look really seamless, because I feel like I said, a lot of like the other petals ones and stuff that people with like larger chests have mentioned and I've tried out, they just do not work for me. But these work. They're amazing. Again, you guys like have to try them out. If I've mentioned anything in this video, these would be the number one thing that you guys should check out, because they changed my life. Now I get any shirt I want, even if it's a deep V, if it's backless, like I get it, because now I feel like I can actually wear them. Okay. I actually want to mention a game. So this is Family Feud, okay? I would say me and Tasha, that's my sister, we're pretty big on the game section at Target. So I don't know if this is new. This is new to us because it's the first time we had ever seen it at Target. So this is like actual Family Feud. So we love this. Basically, there is not eight of us that plays this, but this is a game that you guys could totally play like on Zoom. So basically, you download the app and it has the buzzer, but we literally just keep the box and smack the box because it doesn't tell you who buzzes in first. Does that make sense? Like, you just, it's just a buzzer. But this is so fun. So you have the categories. So you have like the face off, and then you've got like, what is it, the 30 second or 60 second round that you play like by yourself, because this is, it's so much fun. So you actually get sent this right here, and you put like team one, team two. Like, you could do teams, but there's not enough of us to do it. So we've just been modifying this and playing this, and it, guys, it is so much fun. I will say, some of the answers like should be on the board or not on the board, but it's really cool. Like, one says name a famous painter. Here you got Van Gogh, Michelangelo, like these. And then I'll read another one for you guys, just some random ones. So name the best invention in the last 100 years. Computer / microchip, cell phone, internet, TV, like, it is. It's a lot of fun. It gets everyone involved. And here's something I've noticed about this game. When I watch it on TV and I see people playing and they, like, can't guess anything, I'm like, oh my gosh, it's so obvious. It's so obvious. But it's, I feel like this game makes me feel like when I'm under pressure, it's like I can't get anything right. And this is one of those, like, when you can't get it and they read out the correct answers, you're like, oh my gosh, I'm so, you know what I'm saying, like, dumb. But this is a game that's a lot of fun. You can get a lot of people involved. Like I said, this would be a great one you could play over Zoom. I really like it, so had to mention it. Okay, I want to mention some dog treats. And the reason why is because, you guys know, Xena, she's my dog. I'm an animal lover. And again, like I said, I just want to start incorporating, like, everything here because I definitely enjoy figures videos that has a little bit of everything in there. So I want to mention a few of these. So the first one I want to mention is Shameless Pets. So this is bananas for bacon. It's got bacon, banana, and peanut butter flavor. So these are soft treats, and Xena loves these. She's, like, obsessed with these. And what's weird is, like, I didn't realize dogs liked bananas. I don't know why I didn't know this, but my sister was the one that was actually like, you need to get this. But I went to PetSmart. They had, like, buy three, get the fourth treat free. So me and my sister, like, we all went a little crazy. She on cat treats, dog treats. But these are really, really good, and she really likes them. So it says that they rescue nutritious food. We turn it into healthy treats for your pups, and it's sustainable for all of us. Packaging, it says 25% of this bag is made from recycled plastic bottles and milk jugs, which I thought was really good. But the ingredients are sunflower meal, potato, bacon, banana, flaxseed meal, coconut, glycerin, glucose syrup, sunflower oil, peanut butter, ground peanuts, and mixed something, which is like the preservative. But she is obsessed with these. So if you guys see this brand, definitely check it out. Okay, so the next one I picked out is Zooks. Is that how it's pronounced? Z-U-K-E-S. So these are like the holiday flavor. I did pick up another of the actual rabbit recipe. I think they have chicken as well, but she always seems to like the rabbit one better, so I picked up a backup. But I got this flavor because this is like a seasonal flavor. So these are very small treats. I think they're called like training treats. Is this what these are? Yeah. So I don't really use them as training treats. Like, I'll give them to her because she really, really likes them. But anytime, like, we're out and about and we're walking, we pass somebody, and she does really good because, you guys know, sometimes something that really gets on my nerves is when I'm out walking my dog and she's a Doberman, which, you know, I would never reach out and touch anyone's dog without asking them first. I feel like that's, so, like, even when I was younger, though, like, my parents, like, if I seen a dog, I was like, oh, I'm gonna pet it. Dad would walk up with me and be like, hi, is your dog friendly? Can I pet it? Like, never let your kid just assume that they can pet an animal. It blows my mind. I'm sorry. Like, that's just how I was raised because, one, you don't know that dog. You don't know what it's going to do. But anyway, so I do have some people who still find the need. I'll be walking on the trail. They'll be passing me, abruptly stop and reach down and touch her. And anytime she does real good and wags her tail, I always like to give her a treat. But she is not the friendliest with men. And she's honestly not the friendliest with children either. So anytime, like, especially like I said, children will just, their parents, you know what I'm saying, whatever, will come up and, like, pet her. It just really aggravates me. But, you know, she always does, like, such a good job. I always make sure to pull one or two of these out and give them to her and just be like, you know, good girl. Because, like I said, it just, I don't know. But these are really, really good. So that was my rant for today. But it just really annoys me when that happens. So these are, it has added vitamin minerals. So this has no corn, wheat, and soy free. So the ingredients are turkey, barley, rice, malted barley extract, sweet potatoes, vegetable glycerin, tapioca starch, cranberries, cherries, natural flavors, just a bunch of other ones. But she really, really likes these. So the flavor is turkey and cranberry recipe. If I had to pick which one, I do still feel like she prefers the rabbit ones. But again, these are really, really good. So if you're looking for, like I said, it says these are training treats, but I just give them to her when she does a good job, when she wants a treat, because she just really likes these. And they have a really nice mushy texture, which I think is why she likes them. But yes, if you're looking for any good little treats to get your, like, fur babies, try those out because they're really good. Okay, next one I'm most excited about, books. So I finished the Serpent and Dove series. So this is Gods and Monsters. This is the third and the last book in the series. And guys, I was obsessed with this series. It's been like, okay, Sarah J. Maas used to be my favorite author, and I still love her, but I hate A Court of Silver Flames. And I know I'm going to get the hate for it, but honestly, I don't care. Because I hate Nesta or whatever. Like, I hate her. I've almost finished it. I've got like 3 or 4 chapters left. I hate who she's with, which I don't want to say because I don't want to spoil it. Like, I don't like her. And it's like, when I'm reading the book, I feel like, I just didn't like it. I love the smutty scenes. Like, yeah, Sarah, she just knocked that out of the park. But I don't like Nesta. I don't like her as a person. And I feel like, even though, like, reading that, it kind of tries to reason with, like, the decision she's done in the past. And I know everyone makes mistakes, and I'm all about, like, characters coming back because I'm all about second chances. But just some of her, I just don't like her. I don't like her. And then she still turns around and does something super crappy to her sister in here. Like, I don't know. And so, anyways, also, there's something else in that book that I just hate that Sarah did. And it just, like, because I feel like in a way she kind of, like, tried to, I don't know. Okay, I'm not talking about that series anymore. But anyways, I'm bitter towards Sarah right now. So, because I don't like that book. But anyways, like I said, I do still love her and I love her writing. And I'm really excited for Crescent City 2 because I loved the first one. And there is something about Sarah's writing that just how she words her books, like, it just hits different. And that's how I felt about the Serpent and Dove series. Like, all three of these books, like, there's something, like I said, it just resonates with me. It just, like, inspires me. And I love books that do that and just, that just make you feel. But this is a really, really good one. So I love the main character in here. She's very, like, sassy and just, like, because you're kind of in a time where, like, I feel like women are expected to, like, not cuss and just be like, I don't know the word exactly I'm looking for, but it's really good. That's all I'm saying. And I'll stop talking about it, but it's so good. You have to check it out. One of my favorite quotes from this entire series is, "Love makes fools of us all, darling." And I'm just like, oh, again, I just love it. Absolutely love it. But I actually think Sarah said this was a brilliant, full of everything I love. Serpent Dove is an absolute gem of a book. Just like I said, I feel like Sarah loves it. It's really good, but I love this. It's one of those series that the moment I finished this, I was like, okay, I gotta go back and start over at book one because that's how much I love this series. If you haven't read it, you have to pick it up. Like, I loved it so much that I went and bought this series for my sister and I was like, you're reading this next. She's reading the Red Queen series right now, which she's obsessed with, which I'm glad because it's like, you gotta read that one too. But anyways, okay. So the next is a book, but I haven't read it yet, but I want to talk about the actual artist. So this is Empire of the Vampire from Jay Kristoff. I tried to get my hands on every single, like, special edition he did. My sister tried, like, the website ended up crashing on, like, the, which one was it that was, like, silver and had, like, the purple sprayed edges, like, you know what, whatever. His books are just really hard to get your hands on, but anyways. So Illumicrate. They released in their box, because they do, I think, like, special books in each box. And, like, if you're not subscribed, though, you can't buy that book, which I was like, ugh. But when I seen the reveal of that book, I was like, do I want to pay the almost $400 that people have relisted that on Mercari for that book? But no, I didn't. And I love this one, so I'm glad I held off. So this is from Inky Fox Books. She's on Etsy. I'll link it down below. Look how gorgeous. Like, are you kidding me? How beautiful is this? And she even did the top and bottom edges. I love it. This come with a matching bookmark. If you waited, I believe her most recent launch when she made some more of these come with a signed book plate. And I'm like, really? Really, Jay Kristoff? You just keep getting me when I'm down. But this is incredible and beautiful. I do actually have the Barnes & Noble edition, which is the one that I'll read. Because I do feel like with books like this with sprayed edges, when you read these, they kind of, like, it's like it doesn't have that really nice uniform finish. So, yes, I'm the person that has 3 or 4 copies of books on my shelves because I don't like reading my special or limited editions. But wanted to mention the artist that did this because it's absolutely freaking beautiful. And, yeah, I just wanted to mention it. I love it. Absolutely love it. Okay. So, next, I actually want to talk about Owlcrate. This is a little cart. So Owlcrate and Illumicrate Fairy Loot, like there's tons of them. I follow them all on Instagram. They do like limited editions of these books, but this is the first time I've actually ever ordered from Owlcrate. And that was because, so I'll actually tell you the whole reason I went on there. I ordered Stephanie's, she does the Caraval series. I ordered her Once Upon a Broken Heart from Barnes & Noble, the pink edition. Because like I said, I'm a sucker for special editions and I like supporting my author and all that. However, I hate pink. But so when Owl Crate released theirs, I was like, you know, okay. Like, I like it. I think it's really pretty, but I had the pink one and I was going to have to get the black one because, you know, I don't like reading my special editions. But if you have you guys seen the cover of this underneath, like the actual dust jacket? It's absolutely gorgeous. However, they sent it to me wrapped in this plastic, which I'll never remove. Which I know some people's gonna be like, that's so stupid. But you know, don't judge. But I actually love this because any book that I've ever got that's wrapped like this, I do keep it in here because I feel like it just keeps it in really good condition. But this is the whole reason I went on there. But because shipping was, I think, like $15.99 or something, a little bit more expensive. But again, that's okay because I also got two other limited edition books. And both of these comes with notes like from the author on the back. But this one's incredibly beautiful. Like you have this beautiful, like almost like a maroon here on the side. And then this one right here, you just have, like I said, the really nice writing here on the back. I mean, how beautiful. Like, oh. I just love it. Like, I love it. I love that they took the time to, like I said, individually wrap these. But I just wanted to mention Owl Crate in general. I actually got something from there that I can't show you guys. It's for my sister. But they have all kinds of cute stuff, guys. They have pins. They have, like, little tote bags on there. Just really, really cute. Definitely check them out if you haven't. And, again, I love it. I love books. I feel like anytime I talk about books, I just could go on and on. But I'm going to go ahead and stop because this favorites video has been really long. But, yeah. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this favorites video. If you have any other video requests, please leave them down below. And as always, thank you guys so much for watching.